guys, I am keen. This is Weipa. Some of you might have recognized that from when I flew in today with the plane, the bauxite fields and the Embley River and the associated river systems around here. This is Weipa. And I am very, very excited to spend a week up here for work. I'm very, very fortunate that I get to do that sometimes for work. So I have brought a couple of cruisers with me, samurai cruisers, three-piece bait caster and four-piece spin rod, all travel rods, fit in my suitcase, atomiclures twitcher 110, Bassday sugar pan, and I'm gonna flick the rocks here and walk this rocky coastline all the way around, see if I can get a barra or even be happy with a couple of queenies. But I am here now for the week, so I'm gonna fish pretty much every day that I can after work, and that's gonna be land-based most of the time. But I am gonna get a hold of a boat on Saturday, hopefully go smack a few barra. And then I'm gonna go out with Dave Donald on Sunday. So hopefully get a few better fish with him. Stay tuned, let's see how we go. Okay, top water, sugar pen. So we can get a queenie or a GT. There's a dirty water line here, looks really good. Very, very small tides at the moment, they're neaps. There's like two tides in the day, which is weird. There's like a morning low and then a late night high. I've never had that before where it's been two tides in the day. Used to obviously being four tides in a day every 6 hours, but here at the moment, something weird going on. It's got to do with the neeps. Keen as to try to get something on top water. You gotta be very vigilant. Watch for crocodiles here. Apparently they are everywhere. Have a few casts and keep moving. There's a lot of ground to cover here, these rocks. That's Lauren Point over there, where they load the bauxite. Rio Tinto load the bauxite there on the ships. Ship loaders and the wharf system. And the tuggies here in the back. Port of Weipa. Just got a little barra, guys. The fight was very short-lived and it was right at the rocks. So I didn't have the GoPro actually turned on, but there's a little barra. Bell hooked him actually, about 40 centimeters. That's a start on the atomiclures twitcher. Bell hooked in the guts. Little barramundi, right species. Just need a bit bigger one. Cool. Out here, there's a dirty water line, the blue water, the wind is pushing onto this, but the tide is rising. Importantly, the tide is rising up over these rocks that are warm from the sun. And that warm water is, I think, what the barra are looking to do in close. Get that sort of nice bubble bath, that nice spa treatment in close to the rocks that have been baking in the sun all day. Now that water's pushing up over the top. Just got that guy then. See if we can get a few more. He's only a little fella, but I am happy. First barramundi, my first barramundi in Weipa. See if we can get some bigger ones, but yeah. Makes sense why he was close into the rocks. Try to get a couple more. Atomiclures twitcher getting it done, as always. Guys, day two, spot two. When I say day two, well, it's only the last few hours of the day I can actually fish, because I am here for work, finishing around three and going for a fish, but some great rocks over there, great rocks over there, and some deep water. Hopefully there's a few fish around. Barra, queenies, I heard they get coral trout here. I was just looking over here, and it looks like a turtle shell, an old turtle. That's been either washed up and died, washed up, or it's been eaten. Fairly big one. Pretty excited, because over this side over here, it's nice and calm, it's nice and smooth. Yesterday there was dirty water and lots of wind. This is the leeward side. So it's a lot calmer over here and it looks fantastic. Can't wait to give it a go. I've got the same two lures on, atomiclures twitcher and the Bassday sugar pan 90. I'll work all this rocky bay, rocky points and headlands. I'll probably walk a couple of k's today, flicking the whole way, but this looks sick. Stay tuned. Nice and calm over in this bay. I got the wind behind me, so that should actually help the cast. rocks here. There really could be anything here by way of fish species. From barra through to trout, anything in between. It's a lot of rocks. I'm gonna go this way. So much life in these pools. Mullet everywhere, crabs. Rock pools are alive. Alive with life. Another mullet's there. Here we go. Top water. I'm going top water for two reasons. It is overcast, so I like to use this lure early morning, late afternoon, which it's not quite that either of those times, but because it's overcast, you sort of get that darker light, that less amount of light. Things might come up to smash top water, but also it's pretty shallow through here and I don't want to run the hard body for fear of snagging up. So I'll run the top water first so I get a bit of a feel for depth and what might be here. I'll certainly put the, if I find a bit of a deeper patch, I'll certainly go to the hard body. But I just want to see what there might be here. Because any demersal reef fish here, like a trout or something, will rise up to eat top water in these shallows. Oh, what was that? What was that? Completely missed the lure. But something had a crack. Oh, I was looking in a different direction. Something had a good crack at it then, but totally missed it. So I'll shut up and try to go over the top again. Sound like a good fish. Come on, come again, mate. Come again. This time. Damn. Oh. Jesus. Oh, come off. Ah. Damn. Far out. Let's try that again. Same spot. It felt the hook, though. Oh, yeah. Back. I was going to say, I don't think he'll be back, but he's back. What have we got? It's a cod, is it? Oh, just a cod. Got me excited though. Only a cod would be stupid enough to eat it twice in a row. I was just about to say, I don't think that fish would be back because it felt the hooks, but yeah, it's a cod, so of course it would. Oh well, it's a fish on top water. A mullet in there. Heaps of bait here in these pools. Oh yeah, what do we got? Come here. Oh, another cod, is it? Punched above his weight, that guy. Whew. Another codly. I'm gonna stay there while I get me pliers out. Another cod on surface amongst these rocks. Yeah. Oh, keep your head up. Come here. Another cod. Oh, cod everywhere in here. A bit bigger. Oh, come off. All right, that's all right. He's just sitting there too, look. Righto guys, there's a colour change out there. There's definitely some deeper water, so I'm going to run the hard body. It certainly is very windy though. But hoping there could be a barra out on these points. This deeper water, this rocky headland. I'm going to run the hard body now. Something I've been wanting to do all afternoon. It's always been too shallow to run it. I think I might have found a decent spot here now. Certainly windy. Let's see. I spent my last half an hour here. Barracuda. Oh, the wrong barra, mate. Far out. Shaking its head. I thought I had a good barramundi then. Oh, scared the life out of me, but I tell ya, far out. I thought I had a good fish. Vermin. Honestly, the way it shook its head and the size of it, I thought it was a barra. Barramundi, not a barracuda. Better get my lure back because I want this lure. Lucky I didn't get bitten off. These things have massive teeth. 60 pound leader, that should be sweet. Yeah. All right. Fair animal. Fair bloody animal. It's not what I came here for. Well, that was different. I called it for a barra, and technically it was a barra, but it was a barracuda, not barramundi. Decent sized fish though, big teeth. Smash the lure. Atomic Slim Twitcher again. Nice fish. Atomic Slim Twitcher getting it done. Awesome. Come here, mate. Come here. I'll let you go. Come on. Don't go stupid. Don't go stupid. Take it easy, bro. Take it easy, bro. Just stay there. Stay there. Woo. Okay. Try to get this guy back in the water ASAP. Go on. Go on. Backwards and upside down, but I think you're going to live. Just got this little black spot estuary cod, and he's not long eating a silver bitty and some crabs by the looks. Let's see if I can get that fish out. Oh, I better get the lure out first. Well, this guy's been chewing on a little fish. Not long eating him. And a bunch of crab guts and jelly prawns and all sorts of nasty stuff. Well, it's very deep water here. It goes off to where the ship loaders and the trestles are and the ship, so that's got to be 20 meters deep at least, if not 30 meters over there. So I'm here at a structure, I'm gonna fish it here, so it's very deep. I'll probably change to a plastic or a vibe just so I can get down. Slim Twitch is not gonna get down very deep here, so I'll try for 5 minutes, and if no good, I'll change it up. Loading bauxite, shipped around the world, out of Weipa. Fueling the economy. Stingray there. Pretty blue spots. Hey guys, final afternoon in Weipa, unfortunately. I've really enjoyed my time here. I've got about another 2 hours to burn. My last land-based fishing session, and it's back actually where I started. This is the very first place I came on my first day here. I did get a little barra that day. I'm gonna give it another go. It's definitely a lot calmer than when I was here last. The tide's a bit lower, but certainly much better conditions wind-wise. So I'm gonna see how I go. It's certainly a lot warmer today too, which is good. The last week's been windy and it's been cool. It's been hard work. Even for Weipa, the local guys are saying it's definitely been hard work. So, got a few barra, a lot of little ones, but it's probably not too bad going, so I've been told, for the time of year. Today is certainly a bit warmer and the wind's dropped, so see if I can get a couple today. Definitely probably the best conditions out of the whole 7-8 days I've been here. Oh, yep. Oh, yes. What is it? It's a blue salmon. Oh, geez. Blue salmon, I think. So the blue are a little thready. I'm going alongside because the oyster rocks are sharp. They're sticking out a fair way, but where are ya? Oh, geez. Oh, she's going for a lap. Good fish or what? Oh, jeez, going hard. Where are ya? Oh, okay, I'll fight you from here. No, still going, still going. Don't cut me off on the rocks, you bugger. Oh, oh, come here. It's a blue, it's just a blue salmon. Oh, geez, he fought hard, but punched really, really above his weight. Oh, blue salmon. Well, that's a good start. It's like the third cast. That's actually pretty solid fish. Hey, that's not a bad fish at all. Oh, that's a great fish. He's definitely more solid than I thought he was. Hence the reason he was giving me a bit of curry. That's cool. Been here less than 5 minutes. Putting this guy back. Come on, mate. You're good. Good to go. Pretty happy with that fish. Literally less than 5 minutes I've been here and I had a good fish. A good hit, then a good fish, and I had to run 30 meters down the bank so he didn't cut me off on the oyster rocks because he was going straight along the bank. And with a short bait cast rod like this, a samurai cruiser, I don't have much leverage and I don't have much clearance when he wants to go that way, so I have to go with it. But yeah, it was a good little fight. Atomic Slim Twitcher, 110, pretty much the same lure I've been using most of the time I've been here. Done really well there, again. These lures work so well. Barra, salmon, caught jacks on them. Caught a bunch of different species on these now. I'd be so stoked with the barramundi. Like I was saying, really good conditions here today. Maybe that's going to be the difference. It started to heat up, less wind. There's a dirty water line, that's for sure, which is what I actually like, having that color change. Bait will sit in that. Bigger fish will sit in that dirty water line and ambush stuff. So I'll work all these rocks for the next 100 meters and see what I can catch in the next 2 hours.